Introverts are generally calm and peaceful types. They are relatively easy to handle and get along with. However, make sure to beware of these 10 things that make introverts lose respect for you. 10. Always waiting until the last minute. How am I supposed to prepare? Whether it is making plans or asking them a favor, it is never a good idea for anyone to inform an introvert of something at the last minute. As most of them are planners, they face the day with a specific strategy and timeline in mind. Introverts do their best to stick to whatever method they have formed. They appreciate and respond best to clear details and organized work, as they share these values themselves. Of course, there will be setbacks that they will soon learn to tackle along the way. So to work smoothly with an introvert, give them a heads up to ensure that they have enough time to make the necessary adjustments. Constantly waiting until the last minute to tell them anything can make them lose respect for you. 9. Interrupting. Who likes to be interrupted? I bet no one, especially not introverts. As most people notice, introverts do not speak much. They prefer to observe and gather information before coming up with what to say. So when they finally get all the facts together and decide to share what is on their mind, it can be irritating when someone suddenly interrupts them in the mid-sentence. Aside from just speaking, their hate for being interrupted also applies to tasks they are doing. Whether it is work-related, schoolwork, homework, or even reading a book to pass time, introverts hate it when they are interrupted. Having a low threshold for stimuli, introverts like doing one thing at a time to maximize their efficiency. 8. Not respecting their free time. But I thought you said you weren't doing anything. Being an introvert has more to do with energy than temperament. When introverts wake up after a good night's rest, they feel energized and ready to face the world. When they interact with people, this energy is slowly used up until it gets drained. To recharge their social battery, introverts need to spare some time for themselves. This time can be used to do many things like watching a movie, reading a book, playing a video game, and other hobbies they have. But they can also choose to not do anything with the time they allot for themselves. So having someone expect them to give up this free time and go do other things with them can make an introvert lose their respect for that person. 7. Butting in on private conversations. I can't help but overhear, but can I just say, this statement grinds an introvert's gears. Introverts do not necessarily enjoy meeting new people. They hate the whole social song and dance one has to do when meeting others for the first time. The small talk and the unfamiliar face are enough to choose to keep to themselves. So when someone butts in on a private conversation they were having, it is quite understandable why they would immediately hate that person. Being extra private people, introverts do not appreciate others listening in and much less commenting on their business. 6. Attention-seeking attitude. Are they always like that? Even observing people with obvious attention-seeking behavior can be exhausting for the introvert. Contrary to this, introverts hate drawing attention to themselves. They try to be as discreet and private as possible, making sure they do not attract unwanted attention which they cannot handle. People who behave in such a "look at me" way immediately lose an introvert's respect. But make no mistake, they still are going to treat them as cordially as necessary. However, there is little to no chance at all of them both becoming friends. Since introverts make a few friends and keep even fewer, they make sure that the people they do keep in their lives are worthy of their trust and respect. 5. Involving them in drama. Why do introverts hate drama? Drama can entertain when seen on screen or when read in a book. It can even be fun to hear about it from a friend, but it stops being fun when it starts to involve you. Drama is only great when witnessed from afar. But once you start playing a part in these strange events, you realize it is not so great after all. This is what regular folks feel about drama. Introverts, with their limited social energy, hate it even more. Just thinking about drama makes them tired. So when someone tries to drag them into this mess, they take offense. Instead of being involved in drama, introverts have so much better ways to spend their time and energy on. Avoiding this mess is one of the reasons why they choose to bond with only a small group of friends. 4. Turning a dialogue into a monologue. Do you want to hear my thoughts, or do you simply need an audience? Often being tagged as the silent types, introverts typically do not speak or engage much in conversation. But just because they choose to listen more than speak does not mean they have nothing to say. Introverts have vast storage of facts and opinions about different topics. Assuming they have nothing to say because they are typically silent is a really bad idea. One of an introvert's pet peeves is being used as a sounding board for whatever the other person wants to say, without giving them a chance to speak up and give their input. People should never underestimate someone's knowledge just because they are silent. As the saying goes, silent rivers run deep. 3. Gossiping. Don't we all love a bit of juicy gossip from time to time? Introverts are also human, which means stories, especially about people they know, can pique their interest. However, when this becomes the only topic of conversation, introverts quickly lose interest. Being the kind of people who value their privacy, introverts do not divulge personal information willy-nilly. This means that it also makes them quite uncomfortable to hear so much gossip going around. Like small talk, introverts consider gossip to be insignificant and meaningless. They would much rather talk about things that do matter. Having deep conversations with others is an introvert's favorite thing. They can talk for hours on end. 2. Disrespecting personal boundaries. How important are boundaries to introverts? For introverts to feel safe in a world bustling with sounds and sensations, they need to set up boundaries. Boundaries are there to protect them from feeling too overwhelmed and emotionally exhausted when they are not ready. It is unavoidable for others to cross lines sometimes, and even though this can be quite annoying, introverts understand this. However, when their boundaries are crossed constantly and obviously on purpose, this is when they start losing their respect for that certain person. To keep an introvert happy and on your side, it is important to be aware of the things they do and do not want someone to do. If unsure, you can always just ask. 1. Putting them in the spotlight. How fun is it to catch everyone's attention? For introverts, not fun at all. Being forced into the spotlight is an introvert's nightmare. They hate feeling everyone stares and the weight of the expectation that puts on their shoulders. Is it their birthday and you want to make them happy? Instead of throwing them a surprise party with everyone involved, or having the waiters sing them the birthday song in a crowded restaurant, why don't you try dinner for two? Or perhaps a great home-cooked meal and a movie marathon. Being placed in the spotlight might not be such a big deal for most and even can be enjoyable for some. However, introverts are wired differently from the rest. Putting them through this experience can traumatize the extremely introverted folk, making them hate a supposedly enjoyable day and lose respect for whoever made it happen. A common misconception of introversion is hating people and not caring for them at all. This simply is not true. With all these things mentioned that irritate an introvert to the point of losing their respect for the person doing them, it is important to take note that it is the behavior that drives them away and not the people themselves. Typically respectful and easygoing people, introverts are still human and are entitled to their opinions and reactions. Do you think you are a certified introvert? What behaviors that others have shown you have made you lose your respect for them?